For art to exist, there must be three main elements: the creator, the audience, and the created. The idea that an object could be or become a work of art emerged in Italy during the 15th and 16th century. But beyond Italy, French and Dutch painters were already rapidly employing the technique of repoussoir, meaning to push back. Always one main subject or character gazing in the direction of the audience. And the subjects or objects in the background would typically appear smaller, somehow creating an illusion of depth, which really helped to pull the focus into a specific area of interest. But how has time progressed, late 19th century contemporaries like Tolstoy. Well, he believed that art must create a specific emotional link between viewer and audience, one that affects the audience. So, Raphael's Madonna, Titian's Venus, and well, other famous works, well, they began to be scrutinized and questioned like never before. Well, did these works only affect the audience because it subjugated him to being a voyeur? Even if we look at today's discourse, like famous art critic Arthur Dantzel, well, he believes that, well, you can't call something art or not art anymore. That's all finished. Does this mean that anything can be distinguished as art? Despite the questions that have arisen, it's clear that the relationship between the creator, the viewer, and the created is, you know, is constantly shifting and being renegotiated.
Bitch.